Okay, so as you can all see by the title of the video, just going over how to easily counter Towa, as she breaks a lot of games when it comes to Hero Colosseum. So I find the easiest way is to either come up with a team that has relatively the same amount of attack and speed. Make sure it's decent enough though. And granted, there aren't a whole lot of figures in the game that have that capability, but in my opinion, the best one that's going to be your go-to is the Trunks figure I'll be showing off. It's part of my main deck. I've already shown him off. He's really, really good. And we're gonna go into the few free battle. By the way, if anyone's been wondering where the heck I've been, new job, working on getting moved out and everything. So a lot of my time, unfortunately, has been going towards that. But things are thankfully looking up. I'm really, really enjoying the new job. Everyone over there is super cool and really nice. And the building is like one big family, is the best way to describe it. It's very welcoming. It's a great place to work. I'm very happy with where I'm at right now. And I suppose the only real issue with trying to get a counter on Towa is you need to make sure your team can survive the onslaught of the rest of Towa's team, because if your figures aren't up to par, you're just asking to lose anyway. It won't matter if you have an answer to Towa. And unfortunately, as everyone knows, she breaks the majority of this game in half. It is what it is, and I'm not sure why they decided to do that, but unfortunately, that's what we're all dealing with. And aside from healing everybody, I would say she has, in my opinion anyway, the worst ultimate in the game as far as damage goes. It only deals 100. It's like, what's the point? You might as well just not deal any damage at all. Give me a sec. I see an annoying speck on my screen. Really sick of these. And that is why I recommend using a microfiber cloth, because you will not scratch at the screen using one of those. Like, use paper towels, you're just asking to scratch up your screen. Same can be said, unfortunately, with glasses. Before I got laser eye surgery, I was wearing those for quite a while, and the one pair I had, it got scratched up so bad with paper towels, I unfortunately had to get a replacement pair. And then very shortly after that is when I got the laser eye surgery. I might as well not even gotten the extra pair, and I felt kind of bad too, because my mom actually is the one who helped fund the both the first and second pairs. So I was like, I'm sorry, Mom, I'm very sorry. Thankfully, I did find a really good opponent to move into here relatively soon. I can easily afford it. It might be a little bit tight here and there, but other than that, it's smooth sailing. Things are thankfully looking up. And I plan on actually doing that for a year, staying at this apartment complex, and then hopefully getting the loan out, and then eventually after that moving into a condo. I would have my own little piece of land, the payments will be a lot smaller. Just pay off the mortgage. I can easily do that with where I'm working. Like, I'm perfectly happy with just my own little personal apartment or condo. Once you get like a studio or a condo, you're basically set. And I am never doing roommates ever again after what I went through. Like, I won't go into too much detail, but it is not a good experience. Like, I just kind of want to be on my own at this point. Well, as on my own as I can be. I mean, I've still got the mouse to look after, but very happy to look after little guy. He's such a good cat. It's funny, a few days ago when I was just chilling out in my room, sitting back in my chair, and then he hopped up on my chest, and then he was burying his head under my chin. It was freaking adorable. I think I've stated this several times already, but I'm a huge sucker for cats. I freaking love them. And without even realizing it, I had long already killed Towa. Whoops. But anyway, like, once you get to that point where you can fire your ultimate off, turn 5, I forget what turn this is. Okay, we're in turn 4, but once you get to turn 5 with the setup, you're basically set. And I think I've already gone over Trunks' stats. I can go over them again really quick, though. Ooh, counter attack. Anyway, if I end up killing Fear, I'll just go with them real quick. I don't think I'll be able to do enough. Even with a counter. Never mind. Okie dokie, game's over. But as you can see, this deck is incredibly, incredibly effective. Like, look at my figure HP, look at my master HP compared to his. It's a very solid setup. Like, so much damage reduction, and a big part of that is because it's percentage-based, and it just keeps stacking and stacking with Goku on the field. And notice how Goku didn't even take a single, like, point of damage at all that entire fight. But anyway, let's go over Trunks really quick. This is why he's so, so freaking good at countering Towa. He's got, basically, over 5k on both attack and speed. And if you haven't built as an O1 figure, you're setting yourself up for success even more, because look at his posing skill. It's easily one of the best O1 figures, posing skills in the game. It's very versatile. He gains attack and speed with 1,000 for the turn only, but it's more than enough. And then, as I mentioned previously, you want to do addition before multiplication, because that multiplies it even further. If you do the multiplication first, the buff won't be as great. So you want to do it in this order: STA up, attack up O1, speed up O1. But anyway, he's really freaking versatile. He gets all this freaking extra attack and speed, and he provides extra protection to the master, which is freaking great. And you can even, if you're feeling ballsy, you can put him in the bottom left, Piccolo in the upper middle, and Vegeta in front of Trunks to make sure he doesn't pass out or anything. Your master should not be taking, like, any damage at all. And you really shouldn't even need to do that. It's really risky. Like, I don't like putting Vegeta out, usually, unless I can just put him safely behind Vados. But anyway, let's test this out against the Blue Goku Free Battle. And then I'll probably call it there. I'm gonna go to bed pretty early tonight here. Actually, a little bit behind on sleep, unfortunately. And over the years, I've mentally changed quite a bit. And I'm only bringing that up because I recently started playing League again. I'm as casual as they come when it comes to that game. But if anyone is, like, wanting to see me play or even stream or record that game at all, please just let me know. I wouldn't mind playing with a few subs and some viewers. That could be fun. And what I like to do in this fight is I like to avoid all counterattacks possible that I can when it comes to the Vegito. Like, unless he's in the middle, it's just safer, because he'll slowly and but surely get his opposing skill go off. Like, once he gets below 50% HP, he ignores defense. Pretty scary. And it easily screws over bottles, so not a fan. And here's something I don't get. I don't get why when they made this free battle, they didn't build, you know, the Trunks as an O1 figure, because as I've done in Stray quite a few times, he's freaking amazing as an O1 figure. Like, there's no reason not to run him as an O1 figure, in my opinion. And yeah, it sucks because a lot of players don't really do the O1 figure thing just because they're kind of out of the meta. But if it, like, comes to facing an O1 figure, it's really good to have one of your own just in case. And with the setup I use, you should be just fine. You know, granted, you can even get the setup in the first place, because like, all the figures and posing skills I got, it's no secret I used tools to get them all. Including getting all those freaking TP medals. But I've gone over, like, just how long I've been in those summoning grinding sessions. The worst one I had, and I mentioned this quite a few times already, is with the original Attack UI Goku, where it took me over 17 straight hours just to get one of them. I was not happy. And it's funny, too, that was like the last figure of that entire new batch at the time that I needed. And then after that, I was like, okay, you know what? I'm not doing this anymore. Hopefully someone genius out there exists that can, you know, make tools to bypass all that BS. And thankfully, that's actually how I've been unleashed. Come to think of it, I wonder if we'll be getting any new figures at all with the free DLC coming up. And while I'm at it, I've been keeping an eye out to see if Muggs has been posting any new vids at all. I hope he's doing okay. I heard by Rockin' Robo that he still hops on PS4 from time to time, so I don't know what his situation is, but, you know, hopefully he'll come back soon. And I've been pretty busy myself, that's why I haven't really been around the Hero Colosseum community too much lately. Like, once I get moved out, I'll be able to do some more recording and stuff, but, shortly after I move, my buddy Freak and I, we're gonna be going through basically the rest of Dark Souls 3. I'm not too far in the game, but, it's a really freaking enjoyable game, and I think the game would be freaking perfect if it didn't have those, FPS issues. But I cannot recommend that game enough. It's really fun and really addicting, especially if you got some friends to play it with. And I know it's probably not the wisest idea, but I'm gonna do what a lot of people don't, and say screw it, and keep leveling and leveling and just max out my guy entirely. I know that defeats the purpose of builds, but still. I forget how high of a freaking level cap in that game is, though. I think it was like over 700. Like, it's pretty freaking out there. And I unfortunately did not realize that I had my ultimate that turn. Probably could use Trunks there, but it's fine, it is what it is. But yeah, it, like, as you can see with the setup, it's kind of a boring matchup. It's like just watching two rocks hit each other the entire time. That's why I have Trunks here, and I could have been on track to end this match sooner, but I spaced royally there, and completely my fault, sorry about that. And I just realized, Vegito's got his freaking passive up, that's not good. Not pass opposing skill, like, been playing too much League lately, I guess. I I'm on the fence on whether or not I should keep playing it, though, because, like, after a couple of games, I don't know what it is about it. And it's definitely not the community, I can tell you that much. Like, the game itself is fine. It's fun. The community, for the most part, not the greatest, but if you can deal with it and just keep a cool head, it's really easy to get through any game. And just look at it as it's, you know, it's just a game. Like, I used to be pretty bad about it. Anytime I would play it, I'd be like, I would flame people now and then. And I wasn't really afraid to tell a player, like, how royally they screwed up. I didn't really put it the right way. And unfortunately, it did get me into a little bit of trouble, but lots changed since then, man. You know, even with the community, it's best just to ignore it for the most part. Like, just focus on what you're doing in that game, like which champion you're playing, what role you're doing. Kinda like Smite. Speaking of which, if Smite is your thing, that's another game that Rockin' Robo actually plays quite a bit. I should watch a couple of those vids, and I don't hate the game, but my first experience with it was not very good. But it just, it's really hard to play in comparison to League. At least I think it is. And unfortunately, I could have probably kept Vados, but it's okay, it still worked out. I don't know what it is about team-based RPGs or strategy games like these. I usually try to keep every unit I can, you know, if I'm able to. Like, I do that a lot with my Soul Silver game. I still play the hell out of too. Let's see. Do I want to do one more free battle? Yeah, no, let's do gold though real quick. And then I'm probably gonna get to bed after this. Freaking tired. Like I said about the new job, though, I really freaking am enjoying it. They've already offered me overtime a couple times as well, so been jumping on that when I can. And I suppose I'll get into my new shift that'll be starting. I'm a huge fan of it. So pretty soon, starting this next weekend, I'll have Tuesdays and Saturdays off each week. And they'll have me working 1 to 9:30 every other day. And personally, I'm a big fan of it because I work 2 or 3 days and then I get a day off. I can just relax and I don't have to deal with the fatigue of working 5 straight days. So I'm actually a very big fan of the schedule that I have now. Then yeah, I don't exactly get a full weekend, but it's fine because I'm usually in bed around midnight anyway. So it's like this one works perfectly for me. Although lately, I have been staying up to like 1 or 2 because of freaking League, and that is another reason I'm thinking about, you know, just getting rid of it, because I don't want it to get in the way of work. And I like the game, but I'm not willing to, you know, forsake my job or anything else for it. It's like strangely addicting once you actually like start to play it and get familiar with a few champions you really like. The ones that I'm really into mostly are Thresh, who's a really freaking great support. And then there's also Malphite, he's this big freaking rock golem thing. And I know a lot of people are not going to like this one, but I'm a huge fan of Teemo, personally. Also, a huge fan of Quinn, Sejuani. That's pretty much it. Those are like my main five. But normally I just try to do either top or jungle, but I'm getting more into support lately, and Thresh is really great. Like, he's a really great support. I would say he's like top pick. You know what? I think I'm good at this point. I don't really need to put Piccolo up. I'm gonna bring out Geo, and hopefully, you know, we're gonna risk it. Okay, unfortunately, Vegito's gonna be hitting both Vegeta and Botos, but hopefully, Vegeta should be just fine. Hopefully, Goku's weakening him enough at this point, but then again, actually, no, Videl's not our opposing skill. We're fine. Should be. Yeah, just barely. Jesus. I forgot how hard Bara can hit. Like, once he gets a few turns in, he's actually really freaking good. I still have him on one of my decks. It's sounding like my team's not looking too good, but should be okay. At least pretty far ahead at this point. I think what really did me in though, like as far as damage from him, was when Vegito hits way too freaking hard once his posing skill goes off. Let's take out Vados. Actually, no, let's put it back on. Screw it. Yeah, because I would prefer to keep Super Saiyan 4 Goku around more so than Vados, because as great as Vados is, she doesn't have a whole lot of HP, even with, you know, all the dupes put in HP. And the defense is really good, but it's not great, if that makes any sense. And plus, I'd rather have Goku out, continuing to pile on the damage debuffs if I can. Of course, you know, keep him alive as long as possible. That's what Piccolo's here for. Oh god, I thought Piccolo was gonna die there. I'm a huge, huge fan of the Super Saiyan 4 Goku there. Like, at turn 5, I forget if it's turn 5 or 6, around there, if you've been keeping Piccolo in front of him the entire time, you know, he's got over 9k HP, and he's doing, like, over 9k damage. It's ridiculous. Like, maybe I'm far too good. And thankfully, even with Videl, Trunks is really freaking great at outspeeding. Like, this should still get me to, like, 40k, if anything. Never mind, I got screwed on the wheel. Still, though, that's a lot of freaking speed, even with a damage debuff and a crappy roll. Okay, well, anyway, that's pretty much gonna do it for this one. I'll have a couple more videos coming up real soon. I actually managed to get through the most difficult parallel quest in the game with every single one of my characters. I got a recording for each and every one of them. I didn't use any limit bursts. I didn't get any help. No, I didn't have any allies or anything, and I think... yeah, and I did it all without healing. That was really freaking difficult to do. Anyway, as you could probably tell, I'm like half here right now, so I'm gonna go and get some sleep, and I'll see you guys later. Peace.